Mad vocabulary.
Guys, I'm gonna be doing a game in school.
This will probably be our last one. Cool. Depending on how quickly you guys do it.
2, 4, 6, 2, 18. 16. Yeah, I
Jordan and Miguel, Kevin and Jose.
Oh, I want to be Lemon. Just name up.
Alright, get your science workbook.
Beard teams.
Or your math workbook.
Team MKE, Team Kevin, Team Ben, Team S, Team 4, Team K, Jolt, Team Nancy, Team Tape, the Tape 2, and Team Tape 1.
You need to be working.
Teams.
I would have already let you rejoin your group if you had actually done any work during that time.
Teacher's talking.
You're not doing anything. You're just sitting there. You don't deserve it. Okay. All right, raise your hand if you have not been able to get in. Okay. It says, why is the obtuse triangle always upset? Because it is never right. All right, what is the number that can be divided evenly by 2? Divided evenly by 2.
What about even? So yellow.
Alright. And it's on the screen. Please listen. Yes. A number that can be divided by 2 is going to be composite because it's a factor besides 1 in itself, unless it's the number 2, right? But all numbers divisible by 2 are even. So that should be an even number if it's divisible by 2. A number whose only factors are 1 in itself. Okay. So all prime numbers are going to be odd, except for the number 2. That is a even prime number. Any number whose only factors are 1 in itself is going to be prime.
What does it mean by 1 in itself?
So, the factors of 2 are 1 and 2. The factors of 3 are 1 and 3. The factors of 5 are 1 and 5. The factors of 7 are 1 and 7. It's always 1 and then the number itself. Those are the only factors for a prime number. Number
1. Yeah, it took that long to see number 1 to composite.
Y'all need to get a seat. But you can move different ways.
Yeah,
alright. The number 1. How many factors does it have?
0.
1.
So does it have a factor of 1 and itself?
No.
No, it just has a factor of 1. Does it have more than 2 factors? No. So it is not prime nor composite. It is prime nor composite, but neither. In what place is the 4? What is the place? of the four.
Wrong.
Okay, some of you think it's hundred. Remember, anything past the decimal has a TH on the end. THS. Hundred would be like 100, 200, 300. Yeah. Tenths come directly after the decimal. Tenths are directly after the decimal. So the four is in the hundredth place. What's the value of the four in this number? The value of the four.
What?
The value of the four.
Is that correct? You heard that?
Yes!
That first one, right? No? Second one? This one?
Alright. It's on the screen that you should be silent. The value of the four, it's a four in the tenths place. So its value must be 4/10. It is not 4 out of 100. That would be in the nines, where the nine is. That's that place. It's not in the hundredths place, so it's not 4/100. And it's not in the ones place, so it's not four. It must be 4/10. All right, what decimal is equivalent to 1/4? Think about, remember, decimals need to have a denominator of either 10 or 100. Could you make the fraction 1/4 have a denominator of 10 or 100? And if so, what would the numerator be?
Is that right?
No!
You didn't see it.
Guys, I find it very rude that you continue talking. Obviously, we need to go over this because not a lot of it. You cannot take a fraction and then just change the fraction bar to a decimal and call it a day. That's not the same thing. Remember, I said find an equivalent fraction that has to have a 10 or a 100 as a denominator. What fraction would be equivalent to 1/4 that has either 10 or 100? 25 hundredths. 25 out of 100. If we multiply 1/4 each by 25, 25 hundredths. Aaron, what are you doing? I'm done. Go back to your seats. We're not gonna sit here while you're drawing all over each other, playing around. No. Go back to your seats.